Welcome to this video about HTML for beginners. Today we are going to look at about formatting HTML text elements of text. As you begin to place more and more text elements onto your website, you may find yourself wanting to incorporate bold or italic properties in your text elements. HTML offers a handful of special tags that can be utilized to do just that. To save time, I've already opened up my brackets and create an HTML document and saved it as a formatting text.html. Inside the body, I'm going to give a P. And within the P, I will type hello world. And save it. Right in my browser, you see the word hello world. Now this is 16 pixels in font size. And the font style is Times Roman. I'm going to show you some of the most common HTML tags which will modify appearance of any text. So I'm going to delete this one. Give another P. If I type emphasized text, save it. So in the browser, you see emphasized text. If I really want to change the appearance of the text to be italic, I'll put the EM. Make sure the opening EM is on the left hand side and the closing EM is on the right hand side. Save. Now this is italic. Now I'm going to type another P. I say strong text. So this is strong text, but it doesn't look like strong. So I'm going to type strong. Save. Now this is strong text. If I want to type June 1st, 2020, and I want ST to be superscript, all I have to do is just type SUP. There you see ST is superscript. If I type H2O, now everybody knows this is water, that the tool has to be subscript. So I'll type sub. Now you see the tool is subscript. This one I'm going to do strike through text. If I want to draw a line across this text, there's no way I can do it in HTML. So I'm going to use the tag or del. So save it. Now see the straight through. When can you use the straight through text? If I type original price $9.99, then I want to strike through to $9.99, and then I'll save it there. Now see this is straight through. So original price $99.99, And then we'll say on sale. $7.99. Now sometimes you may want to have a smaller font size within a P. I say I want a small font size. I want the small to be really small. So I'll type small. Now you see the word small is a little bit smaller. Usually it's about 80% of the original font size. The other one is called mark. It's like highlighted text. There's no way you can highlight any text in HTML like in Microsoft Word. But we can use the element called mark. Save it. Now you see the word highlight is highlighted by a yellow background. Of course, if you don't like the yellow, you can always change it to any color you want using CSS. Another one is a quotation. If I want to have an opening and closing quotation, opening and closing quotation marks. Of course, you can type these like opening and quotation marks, but they are not correct HTML typography. So you should use the Q. Now see, this is correct HTML typography, opening quotation marks and closing quotation marks. You may be wondering, can I combine the M and strong together? Yes, of course you can. I'm going to type the H out first to create a horizontal rule so I can separate these from the new text. So I'm going to copy this emphasize text. Over here, like the emphasize on the word text has to be strong. So I can come in here and type strong just for the word text. And the word text is in bold. I'm going to copy this strong text here and paste over here. Now, if I want the strong text also in italic, I have to type the EM. Save it. Now, see the strong text is also in italic. Now, one thing I want you to pay attention to is the opening strong tag is on the left hand side and the closing strong tag is on the right hand side. I cannot put the strong in here like this. As you can see, although it's still displayed correctly in the browser, but you see this is all red. That means my HTML is wrong. So I have to cut it and put it back right here. So it's very important that if you combine these HTML tags, the order of these HTML tags are very, very important.